urgent attention. We should be alerted. We should be alarmed at this point of time. Our next year spending is expected to be 20,000 crores. Last year it has not happened because people were not comfortable, they were not feeling, corporates were not knowing how to spend, guidelines were not that much clear, profits were also low for the past 3 years, that's why 6,337 crore. Now it is expected to be 20,000 crore. Here on this platform, I want to share some of the concerns which I have, and I'm sure these speakers must have shared with you also. First and foremost is implementation. We may have a policy, we may have funding arrangements, but where are the agencies to take up this big challenge? Implementing agencies are really very, very less capable implementing agencies for CSR, because CSR is all together a different kind of cup of tea. It is not doing a usual business. It is not setting up a project, because you are dealing with the human element. You have to first assess the requirement of the society nearby and then address it. Customizing to the business objective. Second question, spending must be done transparently. 6,000 crore becoming 20,000 crore, and for if we see the transparency, as soon as the any stakeholder who is responsible for watching the expenditure, whether it is rightly spent, there are internal controls or available or not, whether the benefits have accrued, those stakeholders, as soon as it comes to they may question, why did you travel? Why did you travel by business class? You could have traveled by economy class, no? They will question that much also. Why are you keeping so many vehicles? Why are you spending this much money on your advertisement, PR? Why are you running those guest houses and all that? Those questions will come. But as soon as the CSR topic comes, their heart becomes very soft. Nobody will like to see that whether the money has reached the target society, whether target public, target group, whether it has reached to the last, whether it has been spent the manner in which it is sought to be done as per the approved scheme, whether we are able to get documentary evidence to prove that after 3 years, 4 years also, whether the selection of the agency was done transparently, competitively, the amount spent was reasonable. These are the questions which are not yet been addressed. Even if it is addressed in some part, partly by some companies, but still I am sure no one will have the full satisfaction of saying that yes, we have done the best. Then we have schemes, corporate-wise scheme. Whether the priorities are decided based on what company wants and what society needs, there is always a conflict, because company objectives may be slightly different. They want to have the maximum benefit out of spending of CSR, so that they can grow, they can improve their image, they can take care of their operations also uninterruptedly. But at the same time, what society really needs? So this combination has to be seen, whether priorities are decided properly, whether money has been spent properly. This is a larger issue. It is not only at company level. Once you identify, okay, I will spend 10 crore on education, and you give the money to some institution, but whether what kind of education is being promoted? If we have earmarked some funds for skill development, which are those skills which are needed for the society? How they are being utilized? Whether the skills have really proven its worth, whether those people who have been provided this skill are able to gain employment? These are the some basic questions which I am sure as a food for thought from this conference you will take it. And I think with these issues left to you, we can deliberate, we can always put some efforts to address those issues. Once we have achieved this CSR objective to this stage in India, I am sure our people, team, PSUs, private companies, public sector, NGOs, implementing agencies, research scholars, institutes, academia, everyone will join hands to take care of these issues also in the time to come. I am pretty sure about it. With these words, I feel I am thankful to IP, Mr. Mishra, faculty of IP, for giving me this opportunity to come here. He was saying that he has spared some time out of his busy schedule. Probably always we look for such opportunities to come here and share. And the money which we have, which NLC has contributed, is not enough, Mishra Sahab. We want to do more, much more. We want to grow and do much more for IP, an institution like IP, where in my tenure of 4 years, I have seen how IP has grown, how those resources are utilized, and how with the dedication of the faculty members and under the guidance of able guidance of Mishra Sahab, this institute has started contributing to the society, and particularly education, management education, in a big way now. With these words, I thank you all for hearing me patiently.